So next we will study the seasoning of timber. So the question arises is, what is seasoning? Now seasoning of timber means, so newly cut trees contains considerable quantity of moisture. The art of seasoning of timber is to extract this moisture under controlled condition as nearly as possible at a uniform rate. Now we will study the objectives of seasoning. So objectives of seasoning implies why seasoning is done. So the first point is, so wet timber is an easy prey to decay by fungi, termites, etc. Hence seasoning makes timber resistant to decay. An example of decaying wet timber is, so this is the example where the wood is getting decayed due to not seasoning or not getting seasoned properly. So seasoning makes wood easy to paint and polish. This is the diagram showing the seasoned wood is easily polishable. So the third point says that seasoned timber becomes stronger and more stable. And the last point is, seasoned timber has better electrical resistance. Now we will study the types of seasoning. There are two types of seasoning. So first is the air seasoning. So for air seasoning, the logs are converted into battens and planks. These are then stacked on a well-drained place in the shade. While stacking, care should be taken to ensure free circulation of fresh air all around each piece. I will show a diagram which depicts best this air seasoning. So you can clearly see that the woods are stacked one over the other in the picture. Now a shade is provided to ensure that no external water or no external moisture is introduced into the system. Now these are stacked in such a manner that the airflow occurs very efficiently through these stacked planks. So next comes the kiln seasoning. So artificial method of seasoning or kiln seasoning speeds up the seasoning process. For large scale production of seasoned timber, kiln seasoning is a must. Now I will show a diagram for kiln seasoning. So you can see that for kiln seasoning, the wooden battens or planks are placed within a chamber. The temperature and humidity of this chamber can be controlled externally, and hence the drying or the seasoning can be done as per the desired target. Now let's move on to explaining the differences between kiln seasoning and air seasoning. So now we shall study the differences between air seasoning and kiln seasoning. So for air seasoning we have, so air seasoning is a very slow process, while for kiln seasoning, so kiln seasoning is a quick process. So air seasoning is simple and economical, while kiln seasoning is a large scale application and is expensive. So let's move on to the third point. So air seasoned timber is more susceptible to attacks of insects and fungi, and for kiln seasoned timber is less susceptible to attack by insects and fungi. So air seasoning requires more stacking space, and for kiln seasoning requires less stacking space. So air seasoning gives stronger timber, and for kiln seasoning a little weaker timber is obtained for kiln seasoning. So these were the differences between air seasoning and kiln seasoning. Thank you.